without people willing to support a place for us to enact this vision, this does not happen. Our committee this year was phenomenal. I'm getting better at delegating, and I know I still need to work on that, but the logistics and handling all of those things that I need, James and Jamie and Mary, Sam and Tina, I cannot thank you enough, because there's no way I can do all of this, and I have to say, Sam and Tina, you guys saved me this year by taking on that dorm responsibility, and I am so incredibly grateful, because you guys kept me going on that. And I can't be all places at once, and James and Jamie and Mary and Sam and Tina really helped to make sure that, you know, we had everything squared away. If there were issues, just be in my eyes and ears, because I can't be everywhere. And I'm so grateful for that. And taking care of all of those things, even that I don't think about, which is just amazing to me. Thank you. I can't be here, and Jason can't be here, without my parents and my brother. I know they're not here and they won't see this, but they take our kids for a week, which we now dub what, Camp Bumpa? And it's my dad's name. And if they aren't willing to take my kids for a week, I don't get Jason here, and it makes it a whole lot harder to do that. So I need to publicly acknowledge them. And my brother usually takes a couple of days off work so that there's somebody, you know, something else for them to do. Then I'm just saying, incredibly grateful for that. My kids are now 13 and 10. We started this, they were 9 and 6. Didn't quite understand a little bit about what was going on here. They get it now. And it's always funny because, you know, it's like, okay, kids, I got to work on TMC stuff. Or if I'm talking to somebody, was that somebody from TMC? Was that Miss Jamie? Was that, Miss Elizabeth? You know, who were you? They want to know. Well, my daughter wants to know everything. But she just likes knowing all the little ins and outs of what's going on. But my kids know who you are by name, and I think they're getting the point that they really understand how important this is to us. But they give up some of mom, sometimes more of mom than other times, and I'm just so grateful that they allow me to do that. And I can't do this without Jason. And I'm just so grateful and so fortunate to have a partner in life who truly supports me in whatever crazy ideas I come up with. We truly complement each other, and it's been a busy year for both of us. And I'm just grateful to have somebody who was willing to give up a week of work to come here and help, because it just was really wonderful. We celebrate our anniversary at the end of the month. And our wedding anniversary will be 17 years, but we've been together a lot longer than that. Love you. Thanks. So, on the way here, we stopped for lunch. Dave Peterson's riding with us from Chicago. We stopped for lunch. And I got Chinese, and of course they give you a fortune cookie. And my fortune cookie was, this was my fortune out of my fortune cookie. Get away from home a while to restore your energy. I mean, stop and think about that. Honestly, get away from home a while to restore your energy. And every year, without fail, TMC does that for me. And I truly hope that for some of you, for all of you, that you have found some sort of restoration of your teaching energy. I mean, we get crap for, well, you only work 9 months out of the year. You got June, July, and August. Well, I don't know about you, but I need June, July, and August just to restore my energy that's been sucked out during the year sometimes. I really do. This year has been one of those years. I needed that. But to be honest, I mean, If 4 years ago, when Sean did the first song, and I drove home with Jason, and thought back to this, I mean, we said, well, yeah, of course we'd get together again, but there's no way I would have envisioned that I would be standing here talking to you in Minneapolis, Minnesota, doing this again for the fifth time. And I like to think sometimes I'm a big picture person, but I never really thought about that. I didn't have that kind of vision when I said, let's get together. Because really, as it was tweeted out yesterday, we were looking for the people looking for us. That's what it was at that time. And the response was, yes, this is exactly what TMC was. And we were pulled together by passion. And I never really thought about it at that point, but we were pulled together by passion. And so we couldn't not
meet. Oh, cheaters.
We really, really could not meet. And here we are, 4 years later, and we're on our fifth TMC. And I'm still here. And I'm still amazed at what this has created. And another response that was, I want this locally. I'm ready to have all the things here in my home community. Damn straight, I'm ready. And, you know, Amen. The response was, we started this community specifically because we couldn't find it easily locally. Yes, that's exactly what we did. I teach in a small school of 350 kids, roughly, in grades 9 through 12. I am the only Algebra 2 and Senior 5 math teacher there is. I don't have somebody else to connect to locally. This is my math department. This is how I get my ideas. Yes, Nathan, I'm with you. I want to steal all your lessons. Absolutely. But I'm still hopeful. Maybe I can find just one. Andrew Gale, are you still here? Eric Montesano, who teaches fifth grade in my district, got on Twitter because of a conversation he had with you at a wedding. It was early winter. Yeah, and he got on, and it's like, maybe there's hope. Maybe there's hope, and you know, find someone. You know, Tracy talked about finding someone in your own district, and after her speech, after her talk, at the end of it, I tweeted to him, and I said, you know, maybe this can be a way to get some of that connection. He teaches fifth grade, I teach high school. If he's willing. I'm going to reach out to him and maybe just start somewhere with somebody who's willing. When I was at Sarah Vanderwerf's session after that, she suggested you could find whoever you wished, wherever they are, but by golly, find somebody. Connect with them, even if it's crazy knock-knock jokes. Connect with somebody on a daily basis. Start sharing about your craft and working on improving yourself. So I have some quotes I want to share with you in conclusion. There's three. When I was in ninth grade, I had an incredible English teacher. And the book from that class that resonated with me is the book Illusions. And you guys have heard me quote it before. It's written by Richard Bach. And it talks about a guy who's like learning to become a messiah, an evangelist. Sarah used that word. I mean, that wasn't the word they used in the book. They used messiah, but it resonates with me because of that whole evangelism thing. And when it talks about this in the book has blank pages. And you just open the book and you go to, when you open the book, it gives you the quote you need. So I opened the book yesterday because, well, I have to get the other book. But I opened the book yesterday, and this was the quote. You are never given a wish without also being given the power to make it true. You may have to work for it, however. You may have to work for it. We wish to be better teachers. It's not my effort. It is not the community's effort. It's not the board's effort. It's not our presenter's individual efforts. It's all of our efforts together. We can make that wish come true.
I don't like you.
We really can. I'm a sports fan. Not as much as my husband is, but I'm a sports fan. And one of the things we bonded on very early, we used to go to women's basketball games when we were in college. And so I've always kind of followed women's basketball a little bit. And I know not every sports fan, but you may be aware, you may not be aware, Pat Summitt died recently. Phenomenal coach at University of Tennessee. And she died very, you know, very young due to Alzheimer's and some things set from that. And there was a reflection in the Players Tribune by Dee Cantner, who was a basketball official who worked many years with her. And I just read this quote, and it just so much to me thinks about, just reminds me of you all. And she said this: "You had to earn your stripes with Pat. You had to bring your best. She expected excellence from her players, from her coaches, and from the officials. But that's what greatness does. It inspires your greatness." That's what this is for me. Mm-hmm. I know sometimes we don't always think about how great of a teacher we are.
You should see what yours is. Yours is probably bigger than mine.
But you're not. You are great. And you inspire me and everybody in this room and thousands of more teachers who are in the MidBoss community. Don't you ever forget it. Even if you think it's the crappiest thing, put it out there. Keep inspiring more greatness. It's difficult to leave, but fortunately we have to move on because it's 11 o'clock and yes, I know I'm running late.
Oh my God.
Take the messages that we hear at home. But remember this. It's tough to leave, but don't be dismayed at goodbyes. A farewell is necessary before you can meet again. And meeting again after moments or lifetimes is certain for those who are friends. And I know I will see you all between July 27th and July 30th. So we're back to Thursday to Sunday. And we will be in Hotlanta.
Did I win?
Mystical school, Daniel Forrester has put together a phenomenal
proposal. Didn't win because of a picture. It's so rude.
And I know some of you are maybe looking forward to a little bit of a different
place.
We're headed to the East Coast. We're headed to the South. I'll see you then.
I don't know. Tina, we did the same thing.
Let's go.
Holy Innocence Episcopal School.
Holy Innocence, here we come. Oh my gosh. Here we go.
That's hilarious. Yeah,
Megan's going to be on the
Tina.
Megan Hayes Golding. Yeah. Someone tweet Megan Hayes Golding right now.
She already knows she's going to be on the committee.
Oh my God.
They didn't spell innocence.
She said she was going next year.
I mean, accurate.
Woo! Sure. Penny Frog gets into the Navy. So, Julia Penny Frog. How was it? How was your first math Twitter camp?
Absolutely amazing.
What was your favorite part?
Goodness.
The wobble.
Yeah, probably the wobble.
Wobble,
or the
baby,
dancing.
Wobble, baby, wobble, baby.
Or the Desmo socks. I mean, that's
Oh, yeah. We love Desmo socks. All right, I'm starting to haul. So I have to go. You guys have fun. Wait, one more. Oh, kisses from Disney princesses. Yes, fine. All right, we're all going to say bye. Goodbye. So long. Very long. Until next year in Hotlanta. Woo! Hi, Siri. Say hi. So good to see you.
Hold on.
Yeah.